I was counseling a beautiful couple this morning, really lovely people, and I got to thinking, what would I say to my younger self if I had the opportunity to do so? What would I advise my younger self? The people I've been counseling in the last few days, sometimes I feel that if I could give them a rule book that I would have appreciated having received myself, life could be a little bit more smooth. I don't know if that's correct, but I think that there are certain lessons I have learned, and I would say sadly later in life, that can help us break down the obstacles of life. So I'll go through them. The first one is, life is unfair. Life can be unreasonable. At times we can put efforts into something and not always reap the benefits. People can be cruel, and that can be our ground zero. That can be where we start. Somehow, despite the adversity of life, we owe it to ourselves and the gift of life to find meaning in the adversity of life. Life is sometimes unfair. Consequences. Everything we do in life is a domino, which leads to another domino and another domino. We don't get to act in a certain way and there's no effect, no sliding doors. Everything we do leads to another domino and another domino and another domino. In order to live a worthy, valuable life, it is important to reflect upon your behavior and say, what was the effect of this domino in my life? Where did it lead? And look at that and consider it with self-kindness. It's no good if we're going to flagellate ourselves. We'll be no good to anyone. I believe that our life is a gift, and the gift has been given to us so we can pass it on. Give to others. I don't believe we own our lives. I don't believe we get to do whatever we want with our lives. I believe we have a duty to serve others and to find what acts of service we are here to perform. Consequences. Suffering. Life, the path of life, is one of suffering. We are social beings, as social beings or herd animals, and we just are. As mammals, we are herd animals. There is no argument. It is what it is. Herd animals like to be safe, like to stay alive, and like to conform. That is the social animal. The social animal wants to stay alive. In order to succeed in life, we need to push beyond our comfort zone. We need to take risks. So in order to succeed, we need to break out of our herd mentality, which is innate to us. It is natural, instinctive to us. And then we look at, okay, the human being wants everything to stay the same, wants to conform, wants nothing to change. That is the human. The successful human being will lead. That's unusual. We'll do different things, weird stuff. That's unusual. That's an unusual human being. And then, humans like things to stay the same. Life. What do we know about life? Life is full of change. Nothing stays the same. Everything changes. There is unexpected events, travesty, loss. That is what life is. In order to find peace in life, we must accept death. Otherwise, we're denying an absolute happening in our lives. And we live daily with denial if we do not accept death. Life as it is includes death and change. Humans as they are like everything to stay the same, like predictability. How do we marry the two? Start with identifying. Start with knowing this is life. Life is not about happiness. Happiness is a height. Happiness doesn't last. Life is about meaning, finding meaning through compassion. understanding that life involves suffering and living for others anyway. Freedom. There is no such thing as freedom. We can play with the word, we can talk about the word, we can evaluate the word, we can unpack the word. It doesn't exist. If you look at what freedom means, it means do whatever you want, whenever you want. How does that work in society? We like to have relationships. We like to engage with others. We belong in a structured society. In order for the herd to survive, we require structure. Structure is not freedom. If we have total freedom, we can only have total freedom at the expense of someone else's needs. So if we use the word freedom, we need to understand that we are denying reality. We can move towards freedom. It's important that each person is as free as possible within the confines of healthy social structure. But freedom in itself as a goal is sociopathic, psychopathic. We are social. Therefore, for one of us to want total freedom, that contravenes the nature of the human self. We are collaborative by nature. So understanding that dichotomy is important if we are going to understand how to think. Learning how to think is the absolute ground zero of us finding meaning. Understanding how our brains think, understanding how our brains deny. We filter things by nature to survive because there's too much to remember, too much to do. So we filter. There is always a level of denial in everything we do. There is no such thing as honesty and trust. These are just pop culture words that we use. Honesty would mean that we say exactly what is on our mind at any tick of the clock. That is not always the right thing to do in life. That is not always the kindest action to take. Honesty is pop culture. It's a word that can be manipulated. Memory can be manipulated. We choose what to remember, we choose what not to remember. Words such as toxic have no meaning, and at times we can be controlled by language. We are the thinker, we are the feeler. It is our role to control the language rather than the language control us. When we are susceptible to short-form content such as Instagram, we become susceptible to words such as narcissist, toxic, etc. We need to take very, 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 very careful responsibility to see that we choose the words don't choose us. If we describe a relationship with the word toxic, we are denying the color and intricacy of that relationship. Define toxic for me. It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean we don't use that word. It can be a useful resource. Be careful not to minimize your amazing brain with one word. Be careful not to minimize your amazing brain with one label, one opinion. See life in the true color that it is. People rarely change. It's rare that someone changes. Look at someone's behavior, not at their words. Always evaluate another person's behavior as well as your own. Judge behavior, not words. Set goals with the understanding that when we set goals, it is the journey that counts, not the destination. We set goals because we're goal-oriented animals. By nature, we like to strive, we like to crave, we like to collect, we like to yearn, we like to wish, we like to hope for. All those words are referring to an uncertain future, a future that has not occurred yet. If we think about a future that has not occurred yet, we are placing the control of our happiness in a paradigm that doesn't exist. Planning towards a future can be healthy, can help us grow, can help us break through boundaries out of our comfort zone. But we need to keep front of mind that the future has not happened and we cannot guarantee it. The moment is all we have. So we walk that tightrope of appreciating the moment, being grateful for the moment, sitting in the moment, practicing feeling the moment and planning towards the future. The guru that only sits in the moment goes hungry. So it's that balance. Sit in the present, plan towards the future, see that the excitement of a goal is the journey, not the arrival. Labels. Be careful of ever using a label. You cannot describe another person with one word. Ever. It's not okay. It's minimizing. It's unkind. It's simplifying. We look at behavior, we describe behavior as it is in all its color. We do not label. We look down upon our judgments and ensure that they are reasonable judgments. We're always going to judge to say, don't judge, that's not reasonable, because we judge in order to survive. We make judgments in order to maximize our safety. We need to look down upon the judgments and see that they serve us and serve other people. We are always moving with compassion and kindness while setting boundaries. Eat well. Our body is our portal to our mind. Eat well, eat clean, and forgive yourself when you're a little bit soft about your food choices. Failure is learning. There are no lessons without failure. We do not progress without making mistakes. A child does not learn how to walk without falling. It is through the falling that we learn and develop our wisdom. So taking reasonable risks is part of the fabric of existence. Respond, don't react. I look back at my childhood, my teenage years and my 20-something years, my 30-something years, and I wish that I responded rather than reacting. Now, the interesting thing about responding rather than reacting is a young person will react. Forgive yourself if you react. Look down upon it. Understand it. Why did it happen? What were the dominoes in place at that time? Taking the time to experience a pregnant pause and consider your response will always result in a higher chance of wisdom and a wise choice. Reacting, knee-jerk reaction, that animal instinctive adrenaline response, is less likely to work out. React rather than respond rather than react. Using meditation, a practice of meditation, can help. Give up the need to be seen as right. Sometimes in life we can be right, but we need to give up the need to be seen as right. Why do you need to be seen as right? Why? To impress someone? To feel a sense of belonging? Sometimes the highest pathway involves giving up the need to be seen as right in order that the most number of people feel okay. Punitive. Sometimes as humans, we want a punitive response. We want someone to be punished, to understand what they did wrong. Give up the need for a punitive reaction. All research shows that punitive reactions, punishments, don't teach anyone anything. All they do is hurt people. Engagement. Engagement with others brings meaning, brings happiness, brings peace. Engagement and healthy engagement in life is a part of feeling a level of peace. Look beyond yourself, read the room, see who you can help in your life. Listen, develop sensitivity to other people's needs. Research shows that people who have wealth are less likely to see the needs of another. The more wealthy we are, we lose the skill of empathy with our wealth. Empathy is a practice. We practice empathy, we practice compassion. Feel the fear in life. Have the guts to feel the fear. The most amazing experiences in life are behind the corner of a new experience, going beyond your comfort zone. If we don't go beyond our comfort zone, we'll never do anything new. If we never do anything new, we will never find that particular experience that gives us a sense of achievement, a new learning, a new language, a new travel experience, a new relationship, leaving an old relationship. Choose to face the fear and sit in the fear and say, okay, this is what fear feels like. Kudo. Feeling gratitude and compassion. Research shows that the experience of gratitude and the experience of compassion reduces the inflammation response in the body, reduces the heart rate, deepens the breath, reduces chance of illness, opportunity for illness, brings a sense of peace. Practicing gratitude and compassion is not only about the object of your gratitude and compassion, it's about you. It's empowering. It helps us develop wisdom and think clearly. Kindness. Be kind. With boundaries. Everything we do, whether we're facing the fear, whether we are experiencing compassion or gratitude, always have boundaries. It's no good to give and give and give to the expense of yourself. Be grateful for who you are as well. Always set boundaries. Be careful of being the people pleaser. Be careful of how available you are. Demonstrate self-respect for you. You will never please all the people. You will never stop being labeled by others. Their story is their story. Your story is your story. You're never going to get all the people liking you. And the more successful you are, the earmark of success is having people dislike you. So if you want success, be prepared for the hate. Live the moment, be in the moment, that's all we've got. And the ability to enjoy a glass of water, enjoy the sunshine, that is as good as it gets. There is no amazing arrival. Oh, he or she is the one, or when I have this house or this car. That is an illusion. The reality of meaning is in the smile across the room. A cool glass of water. Seeing a child walk for the first time. Experiencing someone else's success. These gentle joys of life are where the true reward lies. Last one is don't collect, distract, create noise. We are scared of sitting in fear. We are scared of sitting in confrontation, the fear of loss, the fear of death. So we distract ourselves with Instagram, with YouTube, with whatever. The more we distract, the more fear we feel. Sit in the pain. Sit in the fear. Try to avoid the need to collect, to purchase, to see meaning in an object. Try to sit in silence. Sitting in silence is painful. It is a practice. If you want enlightenment, if you want to truly know who you are, sit in silence and practice it. Accepting your flaws. As humans, we are incredibly flawed. We want nothing to change. We want to fall madly in love. We want happiness. Life changes. Everyone dies. The only true happiness lies in peace. Being able to feel peace constantly can only occur if we accept that life is unpredictable and full of loss. There is the dichotomy. If I had my time again, I would teach myself these lessons. At the end of each day, at the beginning of each day, look at your behavior. What actions have you participated in? Where will these actions lead? What are your feelings? What are your thoughts? Why are you having these feelings and why are you having these thoughts? How do these feelings and thoughts serve you? You can retrain your subconscious. That's not easy. What are your choices? You can say it's too hard. And live in the mayhem of the noise within a cluttered mind as it is. We cannot retrain ourselves. It is hard. It is hard in each new day. There is no real you. We are only who we are in this new moment. And then in the next moment, we are a new you, a new I. There is no this is me. We are a sum of our learnings, which changes in every moment. If we say, this is who I am, we limit our growth. This is who I am now. I can be a new person the next minute. You are a glorious, glorious human being, an amazing soul. Study your mind. Learn how to reframe your mind. Learn to see reality as it is, unpredictable and ever changing. Learn that the process is the gift rather than the arrival. You have the resilience by nature to do this. I believe in you.